Bonjour! In this video, I'm going to show you how to reproduce this 3D letter on Procreate. With this tutorial, you will learn how to easily add a 3D effect by adding a gradient to your letter, and how to make this drop shadow on the ground to add even more realism to your 3D object. If you want to use the same color palette as me, you should know that I have created a pack you can get for free thanks to the link below this video. Okay, let's go! First, choose the size of your canvas. In my case, I will use a screen size canvas. We will directly set the color background. Select the background color layer and choose this light yellow color from the color palette. Now let's add the letter. First, choose this red color from the color palette. Go to the Actions menu, Add, then Add Text. Then write your letter. Tap on the letter A in the middle right of your screen to access the Edit Style panel. Then choose the Futura font in bold style with a fairly large size. Now tap Done. Then tap the Transformation tool. Choose the Distort mode. Put magnetics on. Take this node, then drag it down. Duplicate your layer. Select the bottom one. Then add this light red. Tap the transformation tool, then move it slightly to the top left side, making sure you follow the same magnetic line. Do the same thing twice. Duplicate your new letter layer. Select the bottom one. Drop the light orange color from the color palette. Tap the transformation tool, drag your letter to the left and then move up slightly to follow the same magnetic line. Do it one last time, duplicate your new letter. Add the light yellow color from the color palette. Tap the transformation tool and move your letter slightly to the top left. Select all your letters in the layers panel by dragging from left to right, then position them in the middle using the transformation tool with snapping. You have placed the elements you need to create your 3D letter. Now duplicate each layer once. To create the 3D effect, we will first connect the letters. Select this layer with the red letter and pick the red color. Tap the selection tool, select the freehand mode and tap color fill, then connect each edge between the red and the darker red letter. Now do the same with the orange letter. Select this layer with the orange letter and pick the same orange color. Tap the selection tool. Then connect each edge between the orange letter and the red letter. And finally, apply the same process with the yellow letter. Select this layer with the yellow letter and pick the same yellow color. Tap the selection tool. Then connect each edge between the yellow letter and the orange letter. Now we are going to add clipping masks on top of these new letters. If you want to know more about clipping masks, I invite you to watch this video. Add a new layer and put it on top of this layer with the red letter. Tap on it, then tap clipping mask. Do the same with the orange and the yellow letter. Go back to the clipping mask on top of the red letter. Choose this light red color from the color palette. Tap the selection tool and make sure color fill is still on. Then create a rectangle on top of your letter. Now select this slightly darker red color, then select those parts at the bottom of the letter. We're going to do the same thing for the orange letter. Select the clipping mask on top of the orange letter. Choose this light orange color from the color palette. Tap the selection tool. Then create a rectangle on top of your letter. Now select this slightly darker orange color. Then select those parts at the bottom of the letter. And finally, the same thing for the yellow letter. Select the clipping mask on top of the yellow letter. Choose this light yellow color from the color palette. Tap the selection tool. Then create a rectangle on top of your letter. Before making the gradient on the letters, we will first slightly move letters that we have not yet transformed. Select this dark red letter and choose the color white. Then drop your color on it. tap the transformation tool, then nudge your letter to the bottom left. Go back to your layers panel and tap with two fingers on your layer, then slide to the left to adjust the opacity. Now select the layer of this red letter, tap the transformation tool and nudge your layer to the top left. And do the same with the orange and yellow ones. Now let's add gradients on the letters. First, put all the letters in alpha lock mode. To do this, drag with two fingers from left to right on each layer. If you want to learn more about alpha lock, I invite you to watch this video. Select this layer with the dark red letter and grab the red color. Take the soft brush from the airbrushing brush set and use it slightly on the top part of your letter. Then select the layer with the red letter and grab this light red color and use your soft brush slightly from the top to bottom on this area of the letter. Now take this red color . Select this layer and with the same process, use it lightly from top to bottom on this area of the letter. Let's do the same with the orange part. Select this layer and grab the light orange color. Then use your soft brush lightly from the top to the bottom. Now take this orange color and apply it on this area of the letter. Select this layer and use your brush on those areas as well. Finally, with the yellow part, select this layer with the light yellow color. And use your soft brush lightly from the top to the bottom. To create the drop shadow, we're going to use masks. If you want to learn more about masks, I invite you to watch this video. First, create a new layer. Put it at the bottom of your layers panel and choose the color black. tap the selection tool and make sure that color fill is enabled. Create a new shape like this one by starting from the base of the letter. Tap with two fingers on your new layer and slide to the left to lower the opacity. Do the same thing a second time. Create a new layer. Tap the selection tool. Create a similar shape that leans more to the right. And lower the opacity on this one too. You can hide this one for now. Go back to the first layer, tap on it, then choose the mask option. Now use the black color with the soft brush slightly to the right part of your shadow to make it disappear. Select your layer, go to the Adjustments menu, and tap Gaussian Blur in Pencil Filter mode. Use your Apple Pencil to create the Gaussian Blur. And use your finger to adjust the strength of the effect. The idea is to use the effect less and less strongly as you approach the edge of your letter. As soon as you are satisfied with the result on one side, tap with your finger on your screen and tap Apply. Now do the same thing on each side. Once you are satisfied with the result, tap again on the adjustments icon to commit. Now do the same thing with the other layer. Select the layer and make it visible. Tap on it and add a mask. Now use the black color with the soft brush slightly to the right of your shadow. Select your layer, go to the Adjustments menu, select Gaussian Blur in Pencil Filter mode. Use your Apple Pencil to create blurs near each edge of your letter. Then tap the adjustments icon to commit. For the finishing touches, create a new layer on top of your layers panel. Tap the actions menu, add, copy canvas, then paste. Go to the adjustments menu, tap sharpen layer, slide to adjust to 100%. Go to the adjustments menu again. Tap Noise layer, slide to adjust to 5%. And now you have a letter with a more crispy texture. And voilà! If you find this tutorial helpful, the best thing you can do to support me is to click on the like button and to subscribe to my channel to learn more about lettering in Procreate. I'd like also to take this opportunity to tell you that I have created a free course to help you get started in Procreate. If you are interested, the link is in the description. So until the next one, bonsoir.